Welcome, Miss Harlow. My name is Locke. I followed your work with great interest.
Oh, yeah? What do you know about my work?
October 1930, a Marteau refinement plant up in flames. February 1931, Nevada, a weapons lab. August, Liverpool, a warehouse. No employees were hurt. In Bergamo, a squad from Marteau's private army reported they were in pursuit of the suspect with orders to shoot on sight. None of them were seen alive again.
Okay. So you do know about my work.
What would you say if I told you I could help you dismantle the entire company? Even give you a shot at Trace Marteau himself?
I guess I'd say what's in it for you.
I don't just want Marteau. He's allied himself with two equally dangerous tyrants. I want you to help me and my agents to stop all three.
A tall order.
It is.
Oh, this is personal for you, isn't it? They took people from you?
I understand it's personal for you, too.
These are bad odds, Locke. Lucky for you, I like bad odds. I think we can help each other out. But you should know, Marteau's got a new plan in the works. Something about a tower.
I know. Please have a seat, Miss Harlow. We have much to discuss.
Let's go. We have to find this person before the court does.
Divine Mother, protect us and the person we seek.
Honey, I'm home.
Put one down. Took care of that one for you. Don't pay attention. Good night.
Meet your end.
your eyes open, if you can. I can tell you're no match for me. Perfect shot!
Charge extra for this.
I hate the clingy ones.
Area covered.
Right through.
Thank you.
challenge!
Come on. Locke sent us to get you out of here.
The undrawn hand. I sense it upon you. You must be Locke's people. Take me to him.
I'm curious. The court wants you dead very badly. What did you do?
Locke asked me to examine the undrawn hand. Then these oxen attacked me. It doesn't take a seer to figure it out.
It was you or me.
You're in over your head. Waiting for a shot. I am tired of your face. I don't think so.
Perfect shot! Gentleman Jin of Cairo!
Too bad, boys. Where was I? Not as good.
Thank you.
through. I've got you all figured out.
Victory by any means.
Is it bad? Do you need medical care? Look out! There's more of them!
This is how a master thief does it.
It's time for me to go. Did you see that? Bet you didn't see that one coming.
One has a weakness. Come on, reload. Every strike brings me closer to that nation. It is a price not too dear to pay.
Sight coming. I hope no one saw that. Such a burden, being so good at so many things. I'll be sore tomorrow.
You break easily. I like our odds a bit better now.
We can do it. We have to. On my way.
An unstoppable force.
Now, if you just come this way, we'll take you to the mysterious lock.
If I can just see the undrawn hand, then all of this will be worth it.
A domestic servant in Marteau's estate has a lead on the Persephonite and its mysterious point of origin.
The future has a name, and that name is Marteau. Of course, progress comes at a price, and you, my friends, are going to pay it in labor, working the assembly lines until your bodies break down. And then we'll work your souls. There's a place in Marteau Industries for everyone. The living and the dead alike. Welcome to the future. It's the only one you'll ever know.
You all okay? You look like you've seen a ghost.
It was a shared premonition, Captain. A vision of what is to come if Trace Marteau takes the tower.
He was there. And he'd won. Got everything he'd ever wanted.
I dreamt I had nothing. Not even my own two hands. Not even my life.
The door I made. He broke it. Let everyone out. Forced everyone in.
I saw something like a steel mill. Except it was endless. And the workers were all ghosts.
In the dream, I tried to remember my name, but I couldn't. None of us could. The only name we knew was Marteau.
Everything was gray and loud, clanging, roaring, churning, weeping.
A factory that covers the globe, For an inventor, Marto is quite predictable. But with his machines powered by the Brightstorm, nobody will be beyond his reach, not in life or in death.
Better stop him, then. I ain't cut out for honest work.
Don't worry, Captain. Nothing about Trace Marto is honest.
So, boss, is that Marto Industries tip your agent dug up any good, or what?
It's quite promising. Our new source is sick of doing Marto's dirty laundry. She's decided to air it instead.
He's good at making friends. Better at making enemies.
She didn't know anything about Persephonite, but she can lead us to where it's made all the same. Let me explain. Recall Marto's crossroads network. Beacons, relays, transmat pads. They all require precise coordinates. Instantly transmitting a living person across the globe has a narrow margin of error. Every time someone enters or exits the crossroads, the coordinates are logged in a company archive, where our new friend's ex-fiance now works. She impressed upon me that Marto prefers his domestics to be single, and the young man preferred a promotion.
Yeah, poor girl. But since Marto probably uses the crossroads to get to his foundry, you're thinking the coordinates to the place will be in that archive.
Exactly.
Okay, but it won't be filed under greatest secrets, comma, my.
Unfortunately not. Agents, you'll need to grab all of Marto's transmaterialization logs. We can comb through the data back here at the hideout. Wherever he travels to the most, that's where we'll begin our search for the Persephonite.